What's poppin', YouTube? It's your boy OTV, and I'm back with another video. But today, we acting to, like, you know, a Marvel entertainment, like, you know, type of thing. Like a Marvel movie, they dropped for, like, Chadwick Boseman, you know. Because the man, a legend, man, a legend is gone. And we need to, you know, respect it. So let's get into it. Do me a favor real quick. Remember to smash the subscribe button and smash the like button too. Thank you, enjoy.
What is historic acting about Wakanda?
It was Chadwick Boseman's performance in 42 that really made us take a second look. There is such an honor and dignity to the way that he played Jackie Robinson that we knew we needed for the character of T'Challa, the Prince of Wakanda.
Chadwick is an amazing actor who we thought would fit perfectly with the MCU.
Stop. Like, it's crazy. The guy, like, legit, like, get African accent properly. Like, it's so amazing. Amazing meaning. Like,
after one another.
Definitely.
As if we were one single tribe.
A lot of the things about the character are also
true. That's what I want. Like, I don't know, but if people like try to look into black culture and in general wise, like black culture is more of like we want to see each other as one. So like, and but it's hard for white people to find it easy to see everybody as one, but we all we just want to be one, just to be treated fair. Like, it's crazy.
Football chat, he's very knowledgeable, he's an athlete, you know, a martial artist, he's had a lot of experience playing roles that come with a lot of weight. No, so I think he has a lot of weight to him. I think he brings all that stuff to the role. But not to mention that he's incredibly gifted as an actor and as a performer, and also as a storyteller in his own right.
I am not king of all people. I am king of Wakanda, and it is my responsibility to make sure our people are safe.
Because he is so prepared as an actor, and because his character is sort of flawless on set, it forced the other actors who had scenes with them to kind of raise their game and go, okay, this guy is not taking anything for granted. He's really leaving it all out there. So we have to keep up with him.
What doesn't Chadwick bring to the character? I mean,
like, man, I haven't watched too much of Chadwick's movie, but every movie that he does, he actually killed the role. Like, it's crazy. And I heard that it's Denzel Washington that paid for his scholarship. Like, the man is really, he's really humble. He's really humble. Like, it's crazy how people are bullying him online. It's crazy, man.
It's regal and grounded, and he brings a gravitas to it. So all of this feeds his T'Challa, and I think he wore the crown with dignity.
He brought him back!
I've known him since I was about, like, 17, so I've known him for a really long time. Back in New York, he did the work, obviously. You know, I just think he did an incredible job being true to the character.
Wakanda forever!
I had a great time with Chadwick. Just warmth and camaraderie came into it, of course, with a great deal of respect for his previous work. So when I looked at him with proud eyes, you know, they were as mother and also as comrade and colleague and Angela.
It is your time to be king.
Chadwick is
It's like I don't know if he's been into like African royal type of like, you know, family, but it's like a great moment when your father passed away. Hey, it's a sad moment when your father passed away, but when you're about to crown a king, your mom, it's basically like your mom is going to be the one giving you the crown, like laying the crown to you. and it's gonna take you to a time, like, you know, and she's gonna wish you, like, you know, she's gonna pray for you, wish you a good moment through your own time, that people, you know, things goes right in your own time and never goes wrong, like, you know, like all this type of thing, you know. He has, you know, so much, you know, so much about, you know, black culture. It's, you know, it's great.
House, he really is so talented. Every single movie he's made, there's kind of this internal, almost nobility.
The Black Panther has been the protector of Wakanda for generations.
He's such a soulful actor and so professional, so present. It really gives so much to the other person, and he's awesome. And his presence on set, I think, makes that kind of raises the stakes a little bit for everybody.
Chadwick is he's a really smart, interesting, dynamic guy, and I think he was not overwhelmed, but very surprised and somewhat taken aback by the amount of love. It ceased to become just about how well he inhabited the role and all that stuff. It's become part of our culture just as a symbol.
This vocal is one of the most amazing things I've ever experienced.
It's fun to watch just what it means to people. At times, it, like, in my head, I'll be like, well, what does this do for the world? Like, actually, what is it? You know, is it actually valuable in this climate?
It's crazy. Like, it's a, like it's such a soul, you know, like, you know, great person that he cares about, like, what the world, not himself. Like, it's crazy. He said, what does it do for the world? Like, it could be anybody, like, you know. It's not his responsibility to care, but he's part of the world, and he cares for the world. He's crazy, like, it's
and I'm speechless. Say, yes, it actually is, not because it makes people escape. I think when done right, it gives people hope. I found that it means a lot.
So, like, if you look at this, like the whole idea of, like, you know, this Black Panther, like, it's really great. Like, I kind of will lie. First of all, the man, like, you know, it's crazy that we lose, like, black culture, we lose, like, two of our, you know, like, our, like, main figure, big figure in 1 year. Like, we lose Black Mamba and we lose Black Panther, like, even though he's not really, like, you know, but still, you know, it gives us a little power, you know, a little power, like, you know, and not a little power, it gives people chances to see our culture, like, you know, what we are, because I swear, like, not just respect, but there's a lot of people that does not know black culture. There's a lot of people that thought Africa is just a country, not a continent, and if you want to understand what Africa is about, you get to understand, you get to learn. You know, you gotta learn people before, you gotta understand people before you judge them, and that's it. And one more thing I wanna say, like, a lot of people bully this man before he goes away, before he die, not knowing that he had cancer. Like, most of you people that bully him, that say all this bad comment in his, like, you know, in his Instagram post, the one he make before he die, you know, that he looks like sick and that, and people thinking, you know, this or that. Like, it's crazy the way you, like, people are quick to judge. Like, people quick to judge, they don't even say, hey, you know, they don't even check on him. Like, this number one thing, he does not look like that on a normal day. So, why would you guys think that is a fun way to, you know, say some words of disrespect to him? Like, you know, man is going through a cancer, colon cancer, and you still, like, you know, you still have a gut to say something bad to man. Like, it's crazy. You ever will do that, you know yourself. And you know what? It's a time for you to actually, you know, pray to the man, you know, like, you know, wish him, like, you know, to rest easy in heaven. And that's what I can say, man. R.I.P. Chadwick. Wakanda forever, man. Always. Wakanda forever. Peace out.